Welcome to this episode of Bake It Up a Notch Bite Size. I'm Erin G. McDowell, and I am so excited for today's episode because we are going to be making my birthday cookie. Now, what do I mean by a birthday cookie? When I was a kid, for some reason, for many years, I did not ask for cake for my birthday from my mom. Instead, I asked for kind of a giant sliceable mall style cookie frosted with buttercream, you know, decorative edges, sprinkles. That was my jam come birthday time. And I loved it because the leftovers of it only kept getting better and better and better, whereas some cakes start to kind of disintegrate or fall apart, not be as good after a couple of days. So I would be eating my birthday cookie cake for breakfast, like for a week, and I just loved it with the little frosting, all of this jam. So today that's what we're going to make, and I'm really excited. The cool thing about this is it's a really fun way to make something festive that is also really, really adaptable. You can probably take one of your favorite cookie recipes and adapt it to make a giant cookie like this. All you're gonna need is a pizza pan. That's what my mom would use to bake my cookie cakes in. So here I've got a lightly greased 13-inch or so pizza pan, anywhere 12 inches, 13 inches, 14 inches. The exact size isn't gonna matter, but remember, a smaller one is gonna make a thicker cookie and a bigger one is going to make a thinner cookie if you spread it out more. So to get started, we're just gonna mix our dry ingredients together. This is a super, super simple recipe. We have all-purpose flour, we have some baking soda and baking powder, and some fine sea salt. As always, our recipes are linked in the video description below, so you can head there and get this full recipe, all the amounts, everything you're gonna need. And I'm gonna add my sea salt. And I'm just gonna whisk those ingredients a little bit to combine, just to make sure that they're all incorporated together before I start mixing up my cookie. Now, the rest of this cookie is a really, really yummy combination. It's sort of like a peanut butter cookie meets a chocolate chip cookie. And that for me is a wonderful combination. So we've got 2 sticks of unsalted butter, but we also have, of course, plenty of peanut butter. We're gonna add that in with our butter, peanut butter in. That was really satisfying. I don't know if you saw that, but I like literally got all of that peanut butter in one spatula swoop. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and mix my butter and peanut butter together just for a minute, just to like let them kind of come together and combine. And then I'm going to add 2 kinds of sugar. We've got light brown sugar and granulated sugar. You could use dark brown sugar here too. It's going to make for a slightly more caramel colored cookie, which would be delicious. Now, this cookie has a slightly higher ratio of brown sugar because we really want that chewiness because we're gonna have a big sliceable cookie and some granulated sugar. This is one of those times where we're really looking for a lighter color in the final mixture, and that's really our indicator that it's properly creamed. So let's let it go for a little bit longer, give that sugar a chance to incorporate, dissolve, and the whole mixture get more aerated and lighter in color. All right, now that it's nice and light and fluffy, I'm gonna add 2 eggs. I'm gonna add them one at a time, let each one incorporate and scrape really well after each addition. Last thing that's going in, well, it's not actually at all the last thing. Next thing that's going in is some vanilla extract. We'll mix that to combine. Of course, now it's gonna start smelling even more amazing. Now our dry ingredients are gonna go in with everything else. Oh, I keep doing this, you guys. I should just like stop trying to add it all. Once our dry ingredients are all incorporated, we just need to add the chocolate chunks. Now, this is a time where I say, if you love chocolate chips, go for it. Chocolate chip it up. But I love a chunk, and I'll tell you why. I like the gooey pockets. I like having varied chunk sizes. I like uneven distribution, including those little tiny powdery bits that you get when you chop chocolate that are like really tiny and just like basically dissolve into the cookie dough. I love all of those things. I also like a blend of chocolates in my ideal chocolate chip cookie. So this is 8 ounces of chocolate and 4 ounces of it is milk chocolate and 4 ounces of it is dark chocolate. And I just think that's the way to chocolate chip cookie. So into the mixer it goes. We'll mix that just to incorporate. Okay, so now this is the part where obviously all of us in this room are gonna eat some cookie dough, but we're not allowed to say that because really you shouldn't eat raw cookie dough because it's not okay to eat raw flour and some people don't think it's okay to eat raw eggs. So just bleep this part out. Let's tidy this up, I think, and then we'll press it into the pan. All right, I've got my beautiful peanut butter chocolate chip cookie dough here, and I've got my pizza pan. Now, this pan is great for me because it's, you can kind of press it into one even layer, you can serve it right on this after baking it, and it's really easy to transport it, so you could take this with you to a picnic, a party, any kind of celebration. But you can use other pans for this too. You could definitely use a large skillet or a large cake pan. So there are definitely a lot of options. Just remember, this is my preferred choice. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and dollop this on. It's like, you say it's your birthday, but for real. Sometimes you bake love into things. Sometimes you bake a little tood. But you know what? Either way, we're adding flavor. So we're just gonna go ahead and press this out to the outside edge. You maybe wanna leave a little bit of room for it to spread because cookies like this do spread. So we don't want it to get too close to that edge. So we're just gonna press it kind of right near the edge. And if you're using a cake pan or a skillet or something that has edges, taller edges than a pizza pan, you can just press it all the way to the edge. But in the case of the pizza pan, I like to give it that little bit of room built in to spread. All right, once it's all in a nice even layer, we're gonna bake this at 375 degrees Fahrenheit until it is nice and evenly golden. And it's gonna be a little bit darker brown around the edge than it is in the center of the cookie, but because of the peanut butter, this does get a nice golden color all the way through. And remember, when it comes to cookies, it's always a little bit better to err on the side of underbaking them, especially if you like that little bit of gooiness and chewiness. So into the oven we go. All right, our cookie is out of the oven, nice and golden. I cannot wait to slice into it. But of course, we've got to give it some decorative flair. So I'm gonna let it cool completely, and while it's cooling, we're gonna make a really yummy frosting for it. This buttercream, I call it sweetened condensed milk buttercream. Lots of people know it as Russian buttercream, and it is a really, really yummy frosting that I think is about as similar in ease as American buttercream, but it is way, way, way less sweet. It just has a really delicious flavor. I love it. And sort of when I was a kid, my mom would make American buttercream to decorate this cookie cake. But as an adult, my tastes have changed a little bit, and I am more of this sweetened condensed milk buttercream kind of gal. So this starts by whipping the butter. And we're gonna use the whip attachment of the stand mixer. And we're gonna add 2 sticks of room temperature unsalted butter into our mixer. Now, this is another great example. We need to see a visible change in the color of this butter before we are able to start incorporating our other ingredients. So actually, I can add the salt now. And I'm gonna go ahead and, before I incorporate our milk or our vanilla, we need to whip this for a good long while. Instead of being yellow in color, it should be white, and it should change a little bit in volume too because we're incorporating air. So instead of filling the bowl only a little bit, it should take up a little bit more space in the bowl as well. So let's start whipping. So this isn't actually quite done yet. I just wanna make sure I give it a scrape midway through here because there's still some darker, more yellow colored butter around the side of the bowl. So I need to make sure that all of the butter is aerating. So we're gonna go ahead and give it a good scrape, get all the way down to the bottom. you can see already this is super fluffy, super light in color, and we haven't even added any other ingredients yet. So that's what we're looking for when we make this frosting, is we wanna make sure that we've got a really, really bright white color. Here on the bottom of my spatula, you can actually see some butter, you know, from earlier in the process, just to see that color difference and certainly that texture difference. Back into the mixer, still using the whip attachment, we're gonna start adding one can of sweetened condensed milk, but really slowly and gradually. We do not wanna add this too much because it's gonna deflate all that aeration that we did, and it's also just going to cause this to be more prone to separating. If at any point in mixing a sweetened condensed milk buttercream, it does look separated, don't panic. Just keep whipping it. It will come back together. And if you feel like you've whipped it for ages and ages and ages, I promise you, just whip it a little more, maybe raise your speed. With enough motion, it will come back together, even if you do add it a little bit too quickly. Let's add the vanilla to flavor our icing, and we are almost there. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and dye some of it a few different colors, and we'll get to decorating our cookie. Let me clean up my dishes and get a few decoration accoutrements. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and take my icing and dye it into a couple different colors, just cause we're baking this up a notch. We wanna make sure that this is extra festive, festive enough to be a celebration cookie. So I'm gonna make three different colors. And this is a time to go get your sprinkle collection out and pick some of your favorites that we're gonna decorate it with, unless you're not a sprinkle person, which is okay. You could also decorate your giant cookie with things like chopped nuts or candied nuts or fresh fruit, your favorite candies, you know, like go nuts. This is a celebration cookie. Oh, I should explain what I'm doing. Yeah. That's what a show is. So I've got this piece of plastic wrap, and this is a cool technique. I did this on our rainbow cupcakes in our cupcake episode. You can put multiple colors on a piece of plastic wrap, and then they will swirl together when you pipe, and it looks really, really cool. So I'm gonna do that here with my different colors of frosting. And then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna use the plastic wrap to kind of roll it up into kind of a log like this. And you can just sort of seal the log on both sides. We'll grab our pastry bag. We're gonna cut an opening from one end of our little log that we just made. So that way the frosting can come out there in our pastry bag. And we'll just drop it into the bag. This part normally looks easier. There you go. See, like that. No. No. Just put extra sprinkles there, it'll be okay. Okay, now set that aside for just a second, because I'm gonna do it all again, because I'm extra. For joining me for this episode of Bake It Up a Notch Bite Size, where I made myself a giant birthday cookie. And this is not just for birthdays, this is an amazing celebration cookie for any occasion, picnics, barbecues, you name it. It's so fun, so festive, and there are so many ways you can customize it. As always, the recipe is available in the video description below. Do me a favor and click like and subscribe so you can be made aware of all of our new episodes as they become available. Come back next month when I'm making two kinds of sheet cake. I can't wait, and until then, happy baking. Let's cut into it. It's a really big slice. I could fork, but why? Peanut buttery, so chocolatey, lots of big chunks, and then those, that little extra sweetness from the frosting is just what makes it. It's like the best parts of a peanut butter cookie, chocolate chip cookie, and frosted sugar cookie all in one.